Hey, what's up guys? In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to use the healing tool in Lightroom Classic, which is located right here in the develop module, or you can press the Q shortcut to activate it. So the healing tool is primarily used to clean up an image, and there's three different tools in it: the content aware remove tool, the healing tool, and the clone stamp tool. So we'll cover the differences between these tools. The main tool you usually want to use is the Content Aware Remove tool, which is right here. And I'm going to use it to remove these blue spots here. So right now it's selected. Now it's unselected, so I'll just select it again. Make sure the opacity is at 100. And for the size, you want a size that's a little bit bigger than the width of what you're removing, whether it be an object, a person, or a dust spot. So this width looks pretty good. Actually, I can change the size using the keyboard shortcuts left square bracket or right square bracket. And I'm just gonna zoom in here. And let's see. And I'm gonna decrease the size. And to clean up the blue marking, you just have to brush or paint over the area. So I'm just gonna brush like this. And there. So what Lightroom did was it selected an area around the image and generated content to replace it with or to clean it up. So there's an overlay right here. So to turn off the overlay, you can click on never. Usually I have it on auto and I press the keyboard shortcut H to hide it or to show it. So you can see there's a little bit of blue still here. And let me turn on the overlay again. So it wasn't a good selection. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Alt or Option and delete it with the scissors, with the scissor icon. And I'm just going to paint over it a little bit more. Turn off the overlay, and that looks better. So now I'm just going to clean this up here as well. Make the brush a little bit smaller and then paint over this area. So let's see what Lightroom does. So it did a pretty good job. Let's zoom out and you can't even notice the difference. Now you'll see this visualize spots tool. So I'm going to go to this image here, and usually the visualize spots tool, it's used to clean up an image that has like dust spots or rain. Or rain on your lens or anything along those lines. So I'm going to activate this, and you can see quite a few dust spots right here. So let me go to this main blob right here, and I'll zoom in right here. And what I'm going to do is deactivate this, or I can press A, and you can clearly see there's like a dust spot. Hopefully I'm going to clean it up here with the content aware remove tool, and that looks good. Let me activate it again. Let's see, let's take a look at this one right here. See if it's a dust spot. It's really hard to see. Yeah, so it could be hard to see on your screen or on the recording. Even I can't see it with my eyes, so it's probably not even a dust spot. Actually, I can see it now if I look closer, so I'll remove that. But this dust spot here is pretty visible. Take a look at it. And I will remove that as well. So that's how you clean up an image with the visualize spots tool. It's mainly for dust spots and rain. You can see this image has quite a little bit more of cleaning up to do. So now let's go to this image here. I'll deactivate the visualize spots. There's quite a bit of distractions in this image, so I'll clean some of it up. So the first thing I can do is go here, and I want to remove this string here. So there's a few ways to do this. I'm going to decrease the brush size with the content aware tool. I'm going to click on this area here first, and instead of dragging, I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to click on this area, and then I'm going to shift click on this area, and it automatically makes the line for me. So I'm going to turn on the overlay, and you can see here it did a really good job. And let's see the before and after. So it blended in the image pretty good as well. And if I want, I can remove this rock here. That looks good. And let's see here. And if I want, I can click here and then shift click here, and that's gone. Actually, you can see here the blending is not that good, the transition area here. So what I can do is I can press on refresh here again, or press the keyboard shortcut forward slash to see if Lightroom can select a better area. And you can see the different types of transitions while I'm clicking on this. Or what I can do is command or control drag on the photo and select the area myself. So I can select like an area like this, and that'll change it. So that looks pretty good as well. The other thing is, let me turn on the overlay. If I want to manually select a better spot, what I can do is activate this right here, which is the healing tool. And see what the healing tool did is I can select a different spot exactly like this. So right now it doesn't look really good because I can still see the string, and that's because the feather or the transition is pretty soft. So let me decrease it. And that's how the healing tool works. It's pretty similar to the content aware tool. Usually the content aware tool is better, in my opinion, cleaning up. So let me just turn that back on. Let me refresh this. That looks pretty good. Another thing I can do is to clean up this transition area a little bit better. Let me turn off the overlay. You can see how it's blurred out here. So I can just paint over this area again and see how it looks. That looks a little bit better. Or what I can do is, instead of doing that, let me Control Z, Control Z, or Command Z, and turn off the overlay, brush over this area. You can see there's like a little bit of a blur right there. So that's what I'm trying to clean up. And I'll turn on the overlay again. I'll select the clone stamp tool this time. And the clone stamp tool selected automatically this as a source, but instead I'll select this as a source, increase the feather, and that looks a little bit better. And to even make it more better, I'll select a darker area. And let's see how that looks, turn off the overlay. So that looks a little bit better, but you can see the blur is gone, but the transition's a little bit hardier. So you gotta be careful when you're using the healing tool or the clone stamp tool or the transition, because it may not match the lighting or the color, but in this image, it doesn't even matter because when you're zoomed out, you cannot even notice it. And again, let me clean up this piece of wood or this stump right here. For this, I'll just go to the healing brush tool or the content aware remove tool, brush over it. And I'll clean it up just like that. And it should do a good job, but it didn't. So I'll refresh it again, refresh it again. No, it did not do a good job. So what I can do is I'll turn this on. I'll press Option or Alt with the scissor and delete it. And what I can do is brush a little bit better and a bigger area around it. So it automatically selects a better source. And let's see what it does. So it looks a little bit better. And let me zoom out here. I'm pressing Shift Command or Shift Control with the mouse and then zooming out. And what I will do is I'll Command or Control select this area as a sample source and see how that looks. Yeah, that looks a little bit better. So that's how you can use the Content Aware Remove tool along with the Healing tool as well as the Clone Stamp tool to clean up an image. And let me see how it works with this guy right here, removing him. So I can remove him, paint over him, and voila, did an awesome job. Now, going to a different image, most of the time with the clone stamp tool, you can use it to clean up an image. However, sometimes you want to move an object to a different area. So for this example, this bird, I can duplicate the bird. So I can click on the clone stamp tool right here. Keep the feather at 100, increase the brush size, and just paint over this area here. And then I move the source, and I can put a new bird in there. And if I want, let me escape so this tool is not selected. If I want, I can also delete the bird. So ideally, I deleted the bird from here and moved it from here. So that's the difference between the Content Aware Remove tool versus the Healing tool versus the Clone Stamp tool. So usually when you want to clean up an image, start with the Content Aware Remove tool right here, because Lightroom will do most of the work on selecting an image source. If you need more control, go to the Healing tool where you can select a source and Lightroom will try to match the texture and the lighting. And if you want to remove an object or duplicate an object exactly the same, use the clone stamp tool. But it is a little bit hard to use because it may mess up the transitioning of the light and the color in the area. So hopefully now you guys have a good understanding of how to use the healing tool in Lightroom Classic. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe, And as always, live easy, sleep breezy, and stay lovely. Have a good one, guys.